And now as the rain came down this morning, we started getting reports of busy roads being washed out. Here's the scene on the Broadway extension where emergency crews actually shut down the north and southbound ramps due to high water. Workers were seen wading into that water looking for drains that might have been blocked. And that's just the beginning of problems caused by the pounding rain in our area. Police were sent to close down several streets as waters quickly rose, but not before some drivers got stuck. KMBC 9's Peggy Bright is live now with that story. Peggy?
Well, Kelly, it was a lot of rain in a short amount of time. We are along Indian Creek where the water rose earlier and is now going back down again. Take a look at what the rain did to some area streets. This is a spot that flash floods easily, Gardner Road near Shoto. Some bigger trucks mowed their way in and made it while we were there, but not Sadel Suri's mother. Sadel showed us how high up the water went.
Everything in the car is like covered up with water.
At least Sadel says his mom got out okay. Police put up crime scene tape across Emmanuel Cleaver Boulevard to keep vehicles from driving through high water. But a couple cars had already found out the hard way that it was just too deep.
I had a job to do today and I saw a car, the car over here stalled, and I couldn't figure out what that was about, and I was halfway through the puddle before I realized what that was about.
Van Brunt was closed as well near 12th Street. No one stuck at this location. Mostly people worked their way around the problem, but some people just couldn't resist plowing through. Sadel's mom's car and Sandra's would not start even after being jumped. A very frustrating morning for an awful lot of people. We're live along Indian Creek. Back to you in the studio.